Team USA basketball guards are dropping like flies, Francis. Left and right. Technically, their knees. Left and right. Steph Curry wants to heal his knee over the summer. Granted, he's been playing over 100 total games this season, given the NBA Finals and deep playoffs run. He got injured back against the Portland Trail Blazers. That makes obvious sense as to why he wouldn't just immediately gear up to head down to Brazil 5 days after the NBA Finals end.
The quote from Steph Curry actually reads, "After a great deal of internal thought and several discussions with my family, the Warriors, and my representatives, I've elected to withdraw my name from the list of eligible players on Team USA's preliminary roster for the 2016 Summer Games in Brazil." Curry said in a statement released by the Warriors, "I recently informed US Basketball Managing Director Jerry Colangelo of this decision, and I don't want to be swimming around in the disgusting Rio waters in my spare time."
Nice, Steph.
John Wall, on the other hand, who was going to be one of the guys pegged to replace Steph Curry when he announced his injury, or announced that he wouldn't be playing, also was injured with a knee injury and is estimated to return technically July 1st, at least according to sources. But his injury might keep him out of Washington Wizards camp to just begin the season. Nothing to worry about for the regular season that doesn't start, even probably the preseason. Mm-hmm. Well, what does that mean? Well, we do have another option. We really have a ton of options, to be honest. And, you know, Team USA could take their D team and potentially make a run for the gold medal. But Damian Lillard's now going to get the call.
Not a bad person to call up.
Damian Lillard to join Russell Westbrook and Kyrie Irving, who are the other two virtual locks for the position, rounds out a pretty damn good backcourt. It also leaves, I think, another spot open for another player to come in. But we're looking at a team, again, with Westbrook and Irving likely starting in the backcourt. If not, maybe Damian Lillard sneaks in there. Russell Westbrook would obviously seem like the starting guard, at least the starting point guard for the team, given Curry and Chris Paul out. You got LeBron James in there, who I don't think is going to pass on the Olympics, given how much he means to Team USA and maybe the fact that
the international pool and stuff like that.
Yeah, there's the draw for it, the international pool. Like, he's a major staple. Carmelo Anthony likely to be playing as well on that team. Draymond Green, I've heard, is now going to be pegged for a roster spot as well. The final rosters will not be submitted, at least until after the NBA Finals. But, you know, I'm getting a little bit concerned.
I don't think you need to be concerned.
Just like, I mean, not that like we're not going to obviously make a run at a gold medal with the talent that we have. It's just like, what if they all start dropping out? What if we're sending?
Oh, well, you just pull.
What if we're sending college kids?
Well, in the E squad, yeah, you're sending college kids and probably still do well.
Do you know
the luxury that you have? It makes me disgusted that I have to watch my team fall away in every major tournament, not even make it, and you guys can just Steph, no problem. Chris Paul. Right, we'll get another six guards. Step in, high quality. We'll go on, we'll put a win. I hate you. I don't like you guys. This is why no one likes the U.S.
Hate's a strong... I don't think this is why no one likes
this
the U.S.
This is one of the reasons. You're too deep of in your basketball talent.
Of the long list of reasons, I'd hope that's like bottom five.
And by the way...
You guys are too deep at basketball.
There should have been a call minus the dropouts for Damian Lillard to potentially include in the squad.
Yeah,
anyway,
absolutely.
We talked about how phenomenal he was. Snubbed as an all-star. Made it as an all-star, second team.
All-NBA second team.
We watched them take Portland Trailblazers, surpass what they expected to do, beat the Clippers, and then went on to make a series at their competition against Golden State. And it all came off the back of Damian Lillard. I mean, phenomenal shooter. But again, the one thing you got to take into consideration is how is the team going to adjust that much? Like, Steph Curry is such a unique player with his shooting ability and his scoring percentage that, yes, you're going to lose a lot, but I think you're just going to have to rely on some of the other star quality players. Like Damian Lillard undoubtedly has a great shot as well and can just come up in clutch situations with threes from deep. But I think you're going to see him maybe utilize Kyrie if he's in with him as a scorer. Mm-hmm. Maybe look to LeBron in transition a lot more and adjust his game, because he's not going to play the same way he plays with the Trailblazers. He's now going to play alongside other all-star players that he's only going to get better. And he'll probably rely a little bit more on his passing. And that was why initially, I thought John Wall might have been a good player to be considered, because his jump shot isn't as good as other guards, but he is good in transition, very quick, and his passing is good. So maybe he could have been in there just to be a seamless fit to utilize LeBron or anyone else that can get more points on the board.
Yeah, so fortunately, with LeBron on the team, we never really have to worry. Like, if all of our guards went down, and I mean everybody,
he would just play point guard.
And we needed to take freshmen, LeBron could run the point pretty much better than anybody else in the world. But because of that, if LeBron weren't to go and we had all these injuries in the backcourt, that's where I'd start getting very worried. Yeah. So in addition to that, we've already discussed how Paul George is likely to be making that team. Kevin Durant's going to be on that team. So we still have a couple of guys who could pretty much put the ball in the, into the basket more and better than almost anybody else in the NBA in the first place. So, you know, we're still probably the favorites to win gold.
Not Brazil losing Barbosa.
I just hope, like, I'm really hoping, though, that at no point do, like, five more guys say, like, yeah, no, we're not going to go because the Zika virus scares the living hell out of us. And so,
And if you need any more reason as to why a 2,465 game season is too long, this is why.
No, it's not baseball, but that's fair.
It's close
82
enough.
Games, 2,000 games. There's not even that many days. What are we doing, 7 a-days in our season?
Sometimes it feels like that.
Sometimes it does feel
How did
like
they,
that.
Did they not just play the Mavs yesterday? Oh, yeah, they're playing them again today and then tomorrow and then Friday.
They're playing at 1, 4, and 7 p.m. Pacific time today. All right, guys, comment below with what you think about Team USA basketball. How many more injuries could we sustain and still win a gold medal? Man, that's such an elitist thing to say. I don't mean that. But
Yes, you do.
I do
mean
it.
Yes, you do.
For instance, on the score, Maxwell at JasonRubin91. You can follow the social media in the description box below. Make sure to check out Facebook.com/TYT Sports. We're doing a lot of Facebook live streaming on NBA, on World Football, and everything. We'll see you over there.